Hello, thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Professor Maria Sanders with Central Washington University's film program. And I apologize that I look like I'm in an interrogation. My webcam stopped working, so I have to use my phone, and it's a long story. That's kind of a good example of how things have been this year. Lots of challenges. We're very proud of what our students have accomplished this year. So this is night one of our two-night showcase. And tonight we will see some corporate media projects. We will see some music videos, and we will see the films made by the Production 3 class. Production 3 is typically what students take at the end of their junior year. And it's kind of a chance for them to put to work everything they've learned, make a more ambitious film in preparation for the even more ambitious films they will make in their senior year. So we will see those tonight, and we're really excited. So thank you so much for joining us, and please follow along in the comments and tell us that you're here and tell us what you think, and be sure to join us tomorrow night too at 6 o'clock. And okay, enjoy the show.
There's always something new to learn. You can either be content with being proficient at a task once you finish it, or excel and try to master a task.
Everybody that comes out that gives it a try excels in different areas. Anybody open to improve in any area would definitely excel in our program.
We try to produce the most courageous officers, officers that are competent and capable, and then officers that can adapt to a variety of different circumstances.
There's always a new challenge. You'll never fully be prepared for everything that comes at you, and you have to be ready for whatever comes.
We develop leaders. We inspire courage. We are family.
In the program, we often think of these three attributes, one being a scholar, one being leadership, and then one being physically fit.
Officers have to be knowledgeable in all their tasks, so it's expected that you know a broad understanding of most things. Athlete, the Army is a physical force, so having some level of physical fitness is crucial to our job. And leader, as a leader, you have to be both charismatic. You have to develop others, you have to be caring for those that you are in charge of, because that's gonna be your job when you commission in this program.
You don't have to excel in every category, but to be balanced is what we look for. Oftentimes people don't understand that being in the military, being an officer, is a whole well-rounded palette. You're not just good at being a leader, you have to be good at other things as well.
How they've applied in general is that they set the foundation of an officer. All officers are expected to have the scholar, athlete, leader attributes. Some officers may have better attributes in certain things. They may be a better scholar, they may be a better athlete, but all are expected to have an understanding and be able to perform in all those attributes.
Type of people that typically gravitate towards ROTC are people who like structure. You know, the yes sir, yes ma'am orders, and are okay with being yelled at. And what they find when they do join the program is it's not necessarily that way. There's time and place for that type of training. But as you progress through your career, it's a incredible opportunity for professional growth, to learn how to lead people in adverse conditions. My favorite thing to observe is, and I've seen this multiple times, are the aha moments that kids have when they're conducting training in the field. Those are the moments that I like to see as an instructor, right? Is they listened to the feedback that they got from their peers and from their instructors, and then they put it immediately into practice. It's those moments where you see what somebody was really struggling with, and now they have a different strategy to do it better, and then they go out and do it immediately.
You don't have an obligation for 2 years if you don't want to. The whole point of this program is to develop yourself and develop others, and you will learn that in this program and how to effectively lead people. And every job requires you to develop others, develop yourself, and so it's crucial that if you learn it here, you'll excel somewhere else in life.
If you're thinking about joining the program, I would highly encourage you to, because regardless if you come back the next quarter or regardless if you're going to contract or not, you will learn something. You will learn how to develop others. You will learn how to become a better person. You'll learn how to become a better leader.
was alive. I took all my things that make sound. The rest I can do without.
hey, I just live across the way and noticed you were moving in. Just want to say hi and welcome to the neighborhood.
Hey, it's nice here.
Yeah, it is nice here. I did want to come over just, if it was okay to warn you about one of the other neighbors here.
Sure, come on in.
Cool. So, no one's told you about him yet.
Him?
So down the block, there's this guy named Marshall, lives on his own, but he's involved with a cult called the Gateway to Paradise or whatever, and I've just come to warn you just to tread lightly around his place.
He sounds weird, but like, is he dangerous?
So, not towards humans. From what I've heard, he's not hurt anybody, but he has allegedly killed Nate cats.
I'm sure he's not as bad as everyone thinks.
He thinks the moon is a giant egg.
Just because he believes that doesn't mean he's a threat. I'm sure if someone just like talked to him, then you might learn some nice things about him.
Yeah, I'd learn his gourmet recipe for kitty pate.
Has anyone ever visited him to, like, just talk?
To my knowledge, not for years.
Well, maybe I should go over there and, like, give him a chance.
Do you have a death wish?
Oh, I mean, like, we're in a neighborhood full of people, not a back alley.
Trust me. If you want to make a good impression out here with these fine people, do not communicate with that man.
The good impression?
Just trust me, stay away from that heathen.
Here to visit the weirdo?
Yeah.
May God help your soul.
Oni ka ni si mi do la ni Nostar patre I do ave mine I.
Are you the new mailman?
What? No. I'm new to the neighborhood. I just wanted to maybe pay you a visit.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, come on in!
It's been a while since anyone's really come over. I know the other people, you know, I don't know why, they're just trying to keep their distance. But anyways, let me show you around.
Okay. Marshall? What is that?
Oh, that's my meditation center. I take at least an hour a day to pray to our Lord and Savior, Zarkodrax. But I'm sure you're not interested in that. I know religion is a touchy subject. Can I get you anything to drink? Soda, water?
Water's fine. I've been meaning to ask, is it true what the other neighbors say about you?
You know, they exaggerate too much. You know, people tend to take it a bit too far, but I like to consider myself a normal person.
You seem oddly comfortable about talking to... What is that?
It's a special electrolyte mixture that I created.
Looks like blood.
I messed up on the viscosity of the mixture a little bit, but trust me, it's good for your health. Hail, Zorgothrax.
As I was saying, someone tried to convince me that you're dangerous? Said you're part of some cult?
I think cult is a derogatory term. I would consider Gateway to Paradise more of an orthodox denomination.
And so the name on the sign out there is your God?
He is our divine protector. He is the one who will guide our souls to salvation. Our divine savior.
Don't you think that having a sign out there is a little off-putting?
Deborah has repent sinners on her front yard sign. I don't see why I can't have my front yard sign.
I guess there's nothing wrong with that.
I know. What I believe in is weird. I used to think like that too, before I read his good word. And then I saw the truth. Speaking of which, I've been waiting weeks for this.
What is it?
It's a new book from our Messiah. It details how the moon will open up and our reveal our Lord who will deliver our souls into. I can explain all that later. You want lunch? I'm a great cook.
Sure. Do you mind if I actually like take a look at that?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Go ahead and read as much as you like. I can even buy you a copy if you want.
So, do you read this kind of stuff often?
Oh yes, absolutely. Every day, brother. You know, it's really interesting, the chapters in there, especially the verse on raptures. How Zorgo Drax, our Lord and Savior and Messiah, really prepares our souls for salvation. You know, I have nothing really against the moon, but I understand how it opens up and then you know, he brings our souls out and we're safe. It's really beautiful stuff.
Hey, listen,
raptures and
do you have a bathroom I can use, maybe?
A little weird. He seems nice. That's an interesting decoration.
What the fuck?
Ah! Well, hey, what's the matter?
What? There's a guy tied up in here.
It's okay, he's there willingly.
Willingly?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a kink.
What?
You know, like a sex thing. Mm-hmm.
You got some.
Oh, don't worry about that. It's just meat from it's just blood. It's from the meat. Oh, hey, Matt, we're having burgers and they're almost ready. Do you want me to save you a plate?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, my mom only has mayonnaise. I hope that's okay with you. Okay, good. I'll prep a plate for you.
So, you into BDSM too? What's this, ketchup? I thought we were using mayonnaise.
I asked my mom to go to the store today and then pick up that ketchup that you liked.
She knows me well, and so do you. Thank you.
Something tells me you know yourself a little too well. Mm. Now then. All sweet and powerful Zorgothrax, we thank you for watching over our souls in preparation for your divine powers. Please bless the bountiful gifts.
I can't do this anymore. I'm sorry. I've tried to be as understanding as possible today, and whatever the hell is going on, I don't want any part of it.
Dude, you don't just interrupt prayer. It's my favorite time of the day.
Oh, I get it. You're a vegetarian.
Well, that must be it.
Why didn't you say anything, brother? We could have easily just accommodated for you.
You're out of your goddamn mind.
Wait. Was it the sauce? I have mustard.
Get out of my way.
I have hot sauce. Wait, no, was it the bugs? I have other sources of protein that I can accumulate in the
mixture. Shut up. I thought people were just exaggerating and you were just a little bit off, but you're out of your fucking mind. You're just some fucking sex pervert
Whoa.
Who keeps rambling on and on about your fake fucking Star Trek sounding god.
I know what I believe in isn't all that normal to you. I know, but I really wanted to show you, and I thought you would respect that since you came to visit me. I thought at least you'd respect by that, but no, you're just like everyone else. You say that my religion is different, but is it really all that different from Deborah and her kids next door to conservative Catholics? Is it really different at all? I know that it seems strange, but my religion is super important to me.
Dude, why would be such a dick?
You know what, Marshall? You're right. I'm sorry. You know, if you want,
get out.
What?
Get out!
Wait.
Dude, I'm sorry about that.
Want to bring out the duct tape again?
Yeah.
Yes.
People, the food, you know.
Yeah. Why don't you follow me?
Okay.
So here's your dress. By the way, could you take your lipstick off?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so used to applying it before I arrive on set.
Yeah, just remove it before you meet me in my studio, and then everything will be fine.
All right.
Thank you. Great dress on you.
You really think so?
Yeah. How about you get to the backdrop? Look happy. There's much more where that came from.
Good to hear.
See you at the next shoot.
See ya.
Those were some great takes.
What the hell?
Can you not yell? Please, my anxiety.
Your anxiety?
Oh, come on. All I did was push you.
Pushed me? You completely manipulated me. I thought you were in danger or could have been, like, hurt.
Well, I'm not.
You've got some nerve, asshole.
Nope. Just a vision. You seem to be in the perfect state. Let's finish the shoot now.
Guess I should go get some food? Do you have any bread?
I sell guns.
Yeah, that makes sense. Could you give me directions?
I want all your gold.
Hey, I don't want any trouble.
Bandages. The bandages.
Whew. You're quite the warrior. Take this. Go clear out those bandits on Clearview Mountain. I can get you that bread. Wait! You're gonna want these. Safe travels.
There it is, the bandit hideout.
Safe travels.
What about a grenade?
Okay. Safe travels.
I'm taking this too.
Safe travels.
I have an idea.
Do you guys have any bread? Sweet.
it's time for cleaning.
This is antibacterial, man. Just letting you know that your friend's house is squeaky clean now, and you can go back inside and enjoy life again. And if you need my services, you know how to contact me. See ya. Hey, Ma, what is it?
How's the new job? Busy day?
Obviously, yeah.
You're still living in that car, aren't you?
No.
Father and I will gladly open the guest bedroom for you.
Come on, Ma, just give me a little bit more time and business will be booming. I feel it.
You're not talking about that costume you put together, are you? Listen, there's no shame in coming back home. Your father and I won't judge you for it.
Ma, come on, seriously?
I mean, you gotta do something more with your life than just sneakily cleaning houses.
Mom, I'm sorry, driving in the tunnel, I can't hear you.
What are you talking about? I don't hear you driving.
Hands behind my head.
Material, man. That's besides the point. I opened up a cleaning business called Sneaky Cleaning. I was gonna go with Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap, but you know, that's taken, so.
Number one, I ain't calling you that. Number two, you're definitely not my guy. Number three, I'm Detective Bailey.
Should I know who that is?
Yeah! Come over here. I've been this close to capturing a mass burglar in this neighborhood. Up until now, I thought it was you. Turns out you're not.
Whoa. Kind of the real deal now, isn't it, huh?
Sure is. Ain't she with you? I'm trying to capture this guy for the past few months now. whole department thinks I'm a kook. But I'll show them. I'll show them all.
That's real cool and everything, but I'm just gonna clean the house and it looks pretty clean, so I'm just gonna head out, you know, so.
Wait! Wait. The burglar's still coming tonight. I'll need your help to capture him.
Well, I mean, I don't work for free, you know. I need some sort of compensation. Plus, you know, I don't really know if I'm qualified for this.
I'll double your pay for your whole entire cleaning work. Get up.
Double?
Double, yeah.
Okay. Alright. What do we gotta do?
First off, we gotta go set some traps up.
Traps? You think I know how to do that?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, you're looking, you're doing some Home Alone shit right there.
God, you are just full of references, aren't you?
Yeah, let's go set the traps.
Okay. He's gonna get away. Not if I can help him.
I can't afford to spill any more blood on my job, you know what I'm saying? What? You think I'll use a night house for a sting operation? The hell out of here, man. Come on.
Bailey, come here.
What the hell is that?
I don't know. Give me your shoe.
What?
Give me your shoe.
Why?
I'm calling a hunch.
Jesus.
Here.
Just as I thought, shoe doesn't match the footprint. Is there anyone else in the house with us?
If there were, I would have told you.
I'm taken. Now, you said you didn't come in through the back.
No, I came through the front.
Just had to ask.
Wait, why'd you take my shoe, man?
I saw it on a TV show once.
Oh, so now I'm the one making references. Forget it, man, forget it. So what you're saying is, though, that our guy could possibly be here.
Precisely.
All right. Now you could make a great detective. He's got to get rid of that freaking Ghostbusters getup. It doesn't take smarts to be one. You just gotta have the guts for it.
Me a detective?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Detectives are really messy and, you know, and I don't do messes.
Hey, I don't do paperwork. No, seriously, I hate that shit. You want to go in the room and check on my clues while I look for tracks in here?
Yeah. Strikes at 11 p.m. How have you not made this connection? It's so obvious. Bailey?
Yeah. Oh, man. What's up?
Is that yours?
Whose is that, man? I don't know.
It's not mine.
It's not mine either. What? Hey!
Oh my god.
Well, Mr. Burglar.
You did one hell of a job, Alec. Nice work, and nabbed the crook.
And you pepper sprayed him. Actually, we don't really get to do that at the academy, but hey, I'd be happy to work with the antibacterial man any day.
Let's just stick with Alec.
Okay. Huh? Well, time to rub this in the precinct's little face. Alright, get up! Get up! Alright, turn, march! I wouldn't have an ad to perp without you here, man. And you did make that, you know, 11-11 connection back there. But hey, listen. Okay? Just come down to the precinct sometime, and I'll give you the tour of the academy. How that sound?
You mean it?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Like, that's awesome.
Yeah. All right. Guess that's a date, man.
What?
You know, because you're coming down to the precinct and...
You know, I think, just think more of a job interview.
Never mind all that, yes. Yeah. Well, I gotta go back to, you know.
Right. So. Book 'em or whatever you call it.
Got it.
Yeah, all right, cool, man. Good catch.
Yeah.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you around, Alec.
Yeah. See ya. Hey, Ma, I think I got a real job.
A real job?
Come on, Mo, can you stop busting my balls for 1 minute? God damn. Forget this.
This is my good profile.
What are we doing?
No.
Yeah, you gotta be gentle.
Freeze! Get on the ground! Take the pallet! Get in front! Get on the ground!
Alright.
You really think I'm gonna use my place for a sting operation? Hell no, man. Let's go, man.
In life, when we're caught at a crossroads, the answers often lie more inside ourselves. If you got a new life, would you take it? What would you be risking? Would you be willing to hurt someone or yourself in the process? Tonight we'll find out how far Tam will go in order to find her happiness.
Yeah, now that I've told you, I have to do it, so. Mm. Anyways, yeah, let's.
Cheers
to piercings and tattoos.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And watching?
Yeah, watching.
Yeah. Okay. Anybody want to play a game?
Yeah.
Okay.
Parking?
Park?
Yeah.
Park?
Yes.
Do it. I saw something move over here.
I don't see anything. Me neither. Where are you going?
Just to the bathroom.
Alright, well, don't be too long.
Come to the rhythm of the heartfelt pounding. Come to me as I call you here. Threshold spirit, guardian, and protector of my house's entrance. I honor you as I pass through the door. Riding the sound of the deep, drumming, come to me as I call you. Come to the rhythm of the heartfelt pounding. Come to me as I call you here.
Do you guys know whose cat this is?
Yours?
Pretty sure I don't have a cat. Did you guys change something, or?
Tamara, that's your cat, Luna. And we haven't changed anything. The only person that's changed is you. Like, what's going on with your outfits?
Like, where's your normal witchy stuff?
My outfit?
Didn't you tell us to, like, leave you alone tonight? You had important work to do. You're being weird. So, most of the time you don't come up here, and we hear weird sounds coming from your room, like chanting, and it smells a little off.
I have no idea what's going on here.
Well, since you're up here, why don't you get us another round?
Didn't I just grab you beers?
Get some chips and salsa while you're at it.
Thank you.
These fucking assholes. I'm so tired of their bullshit. Won't be long now, Luna. You have to help with your brother. I'll get everything I want. This is an opportunity for a fresh start. A place where the people in your life aren't constantly shitty to you, and you actually belong somewhere. Doesn't that sound nice? Yeah. Hey, where are the chips?
Where they've always been, on the left at the bottom. Hurry up, we're hungry.
What is this? Is this supposed to be me? Good girl. Riding the sound of the deep, drumming. Come to me as I call you. Come to the rhythm of the heartfelt pounding. Come to me as I call you here. Threshold spirit, guardian, and protector of my house's entrance. I honor you as I pass through the door. Riding the sound of the deep, drumming. Come to me as I call you. Come to the rhythm of the heartfelt pounding. Come to me as I call you here. Threshold spirit, guardian and protectors of my house's entrance. I honor you as I pass through the door. Riding the sound of the deep, drumming. Come to me as I call you. Come to the rhythm of the heartfelt pounding. Come to me as I call you here. Threshold spirit, guardian, and protector of my house's entrance. I honor you as I pass through the door. Come to me as I call you. Come to me as I call you. Come to me as I call you here.
There it is. There what is? My chance at a better life.
What do you mean?
I don't know if you know anything about interdimensional travel.
Interdimensional what?
We're swapping universes. I'm going to yours, and you're staying here. Please, you can't just leave me here like this.
Wait, don't go. Please wait. Wait.
White shirt, now red, my bloody nose sleeping. You're on your tippy toes creeping. Look around like no one knows. Think you're so criminal. Bruises on both my knees for you. Don't say thank you. Oh, please, I do what I want when I'm wanting to. My soul, so cynical. I'm the bad guy.
Sometimes when we're pushed, we'll go to extreme lengths to gain what we want. We learn that time and space can be altered with a little magic. But will Tamara really find happiness in her new reality? I'll let you decide.
He was going to make change. He was going to drain the swamp. He was going to change the world. That wall is going to keep all them damn Mexican rapists out.
Pew, aren't you a Mexican?
I am an American. A true American who believes that the election was rigged.
Dude, that was like 2 years ago.
Last November. It was during last November.
Wait, what year is it?
You are the dumbest motherfucker I've ever met, Myers.
Listen, just because you're the physical embodiment of an alt-right walrus doesn't mean you gotta push your hateful insights in on me, man.
What the fuck are you on about, Winston?
Guys! For the love of God. Jesus. I'm really out of it.
You are just as bad, if not worse than him. This is like a stand like goddamn fusion dance between Cheech and Chong over here.
I have feelings.
And you are such a wet fucking noodle. You never stand up for yourself. Sweet Lord baby Jesus, grow a fucking spine.
You can say whatever you want. I don't care.
That is exactly my point. Fuck, you made me miss Tucker Carlson.
Pussy, I've standing up for myself before.
Hey, buddy. You making me lunch?
No, this is for me. Sorry. Come on. I gotta get in there.
Hey, buddy. It's all ready for you.
Why
Why did you say that like that? And what are you doing in there? You can smell it.
No reason.
No reason for which part?
So, you have already taken the first steps towards us achieving harmony once again. I need you, you bubbling fart ball of anger, to agree to take part in our rest and relaxation.
Rest and relaxation, my ass. I don't even know what this is, you brainless clod.
Well, let's just say we're going to a place where your fears will come out through you, and we'll be taken on a magical journey, my amigos.
Shut your Joe Rogan ass up and give us a goddamn pot so we can just get this over with.
No. We're dropping acid.
What
the
fuck, Myers?
What, did you guys think that we were gonna pack our shit and go to the woods and have some kind of whimsical friend adventure? Nah, man, let's make it easy and just get high.
Me, never am ever gonna take acid.
I really do weed, Myers. Calm the fuck down, you damn buffoon.
Alright, I'm gonna need everyone to calm down. You guys are really overblowing this. Look, you guys have been at each other's throats, and I didn't want it to come to this, but I thought you guys would have come to your senses by now.
I'm out.
Oh.
You always run, Ryan. Every time something doesn't go your goddamn way, you fucking run. Stop being a little bitch and man the fuck up!
You know what? I think you're right, Myers. Let's do some fucking acid.
Alright, my man, my boy Ryan, yeah!
Y'all are serious? You're fucking with me, right, Ryan?
Oh, come on, Hugh. Come on, you know, I was being a kid, you know? Maybe it's time for me to grow up. You should try it too.
Fuck both of you idiots. I'm a pussy. I've stood up for myself before. Fuck. Thank you.
world ended 4 years ago. The world that we all took for granted. The one that I took for granted. Reality was torn. And it slowly became an illusion. It came in waves. More arrived every day. Loved ones vanished. They left and never returned. And those of us that stayed, well, we lost our minds.
What is that?
I don't know. Came here about 15 minutes ago.
Peaceful.
every so often, it decides to take anything but your soul. Two winters ago, it took my sight. Today, it started to take my memory. But I'm not so willing to let that go.
I will always remember you, my son.